Now I'm going to talk about the molecular collapse of evolution as the protein's formation. Evolution used to known as a proof theory, but now with the 20th century's advanced technologies, we know that it is now illogical and also a ridiculous idea. We can know that if someone knows something about the protein's formation in a cell, he can easily think that no chance might be happen in this situation, because proteins has a perfect design. Actually, when we think about a cell producing a protein, we can say that it needs an energy producer and also some workers and also a factory to produce the protein. And also, when we see a cell producing a protein, we can easily understand that there is a traffic while he is producing protein, because while he is building some proteins, he is breaking down some others at the same moment. And when we think about the protein structure, we can understand that it can only be built by an excellent mind. Proteins are giant molecules that are formed from amino acids. We can say amino acids, like you can think them like marbles arranged on a string. There are three necessities for an effective protein's production. First necessity is the number and order of these amino acids. These amino acids should be at the same time, they should be at the right place, and also their number is very important. Just one missing amino acid will break down the 3D formation of the protein, and also it destroys the protein's effectiveness. Or the same situation is also again possible for an extra amino acid adding to the protein's formation. It all destroys the protein. So the order and the number of the amino acids is very important. For the second necessity, the correct chemical structure of the amino acid is very important. In nature, we can see that amino acids have one right-handed form and one left-handed form. It's common in nature, and they can bind to each other easily. There is no problem for them in nature. But when we consider about the living organisms, when we investigate them, we see that they are all left-handed amino acids. And this is a very important point, because we can understand that cell destroys its protein and it does not contain any right-handed amino acids. For the third necessity, the binding features of the amino acids is very important, because there are lots of molecules in the universe and they have to bind to each other, and there are lots of bonding features, but amino acids use only the peptide bondings. And we can give an example as a car. Imagine there is a full accessorized, and also it has a perfect engine, a perfect car right behind you. But when you detailly investigate it, you see that there is one of the wheel of it is wired to the car, not screwed. Do you think that it can move? No way. So you can compare it with the amino acids and their peptide bondings. If they don't bond to each other with the peptide bondings, it cannot work. We can say that the cells, according to the cell's needs, the cell might produce a protein consists of 50 amino acids or thousands of amino acids containing. And there are three necessities we need when it's produced by a protein. We say that, first of all, the order and the number of the amino acids, and then their bounding types, and all have to be left-handed. So think of a regular protein in a cell, like consists of 500 amino acids. When they calculate the chance of the three necessities come into being with this protein consisting of 500 amino acids, they found that it is the chance of 1 in 10 to the power of 950. This is a big number, it's an astronomic number. Imagine that you write these 950 zeros right to the number 1. You cannot even write it on a paper. It's so big and astronomic. And also for the mathematical calculations, in 1 in 10 to the power of 50 is called 0. So it means the impossible. So we are talking about something impossible in here. the evidence from now on I'm talking about show you that evolution is helpless about this question, about this situation. And when you think of a complex living structure, I'm just talking about now on, just a protein consists of 500 amino acids. Think of yourself. A trillion cell make you. You have trillion cells. And every cell, like they have to produce 200 proteins. And also they have to produce these proteins in a moment and break it down. And then again, it have to produce it. And think of it. I cannot actually calculate the number if it was by chance. And now we can say that, it's easily we can say that evolutionists are persuading themselves to believe in evolution, but science is proving creation. You have listened to the scientific explanation of a protein's creation. As you can see, they are all created by Almighty Allah.